Hello YouTube, and hello to my dear subscribers. Welcome to another video from Karna. And today I want to show you my my Vita and PlayStation Portable collection. The collection is a big word. Just the games that I have at this moment. And like my DS games, if you see that video, I had stored all my PlayStation Portable and DS games in the suitcase, and I reopened my suitcase a few days ago basically to make these videos. And I was already amazed with the quality of games of the DS, but now I had a run down through my PlayStation Portable games. That's really so many good games, and I'm afraid the Vita will never have not even half of the amount of the good games we have available or had available the PlayStation Portable at the life of it, at the end of the lifespan of the Vita, of course. Well, slowly it's gathering. The Vita is gathering some speed. We're getting Valhalla Knights and the new Ys, so that sounds promising. And of course Ragnarok Odyssey, Persona 4 Golden. So that's basically it. So the Vita is getting some momentum, but the PlayStation Portable, it truly is my all-time favorite handheld. I like the screen itself. I like how it feels in how you hold it in your hand, and the games is really amazing. So let's start with the few Vita games that I have at this moment. And well, yeah, like I said, it's not very much. The first one is I ordered them alphabetically, like my PlayStation Portable, so we will do them both alphabetically. The first one is Disgaea 3. If you like Disgaea, I recommend playing Disgaea 3 on the Vita for two reasons. One, it looks much better on the Vita than on the PlayStation 3, and you'll get all the DLC that you have to buy with the PlayStation 3 is included in the Vita version. So all the extra sceneries and all that stuff is on the memory card. You do not have to buy it. So that's quite nice. And like I said, on the PlayStation 3, Disgaea 3 doesn't look very well. And on the Vita it does. Then a recent pickup is Dragon's Crown. That's a little bit fighter game meets RPG. And yeah, it looks very good. Dungeon Hunter Alliance, I was a little bit disappointed with that game, but it's a solid RPG, Diablo style. You can grind for weapons and find better weapons and all that stuff. Then an all-time favorite series of my Everybody Golf. Another recent pickup is Legends of War, but I have not played this one yet. Well, I seen on YouTube it looks like an interesting game. Then the new Little Kid story, or new Little King story. I was bigly disappointed with this game. I was disappointed. And of course a Metal Gear. And I suck at playing these games, so I tried playing it, but I'm glad that I have it, but I really am not good playing this game. Another big disappointment: Need for Speed Most Wanted. And well, now two of my favorite Vita games. The first one is Persona 4 Golden. I'm still doubting if this one or Tales of the Abyss is my favorite RPG. I have to pick one, but I will not think about it at this moment. So I'll both call them my favorite RPG. Yeah, Persona 4 Golden. I liked it even more than Persona 4. And to play it on the Vita was an amazing experience. And another one of my best favorites of the Vita is Virtue's Last Reward. If you have the option to choose between the Vita and the 3DS to play this game, my recommendation is play it on the Vita. But that's just my opinion. I played this one first on the Vita, then I played the 3DS version. So yeah, I think this one is a little bit, well, it's the same, but I prefer the Vita for playing Virtua's Last Reward. And it's a great, 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 great game. I mentioned it a lot of times. It's a sequel to 999. 999 is a DS game. They both are virtual novels. And if you have not checked them out both, run to the stores and pick them both up. And that's the Vita. So in the lifespan of the Vita so far, there has not been released much to my interest. And now, let's start with the PlayStation Portable games. And as well, alphabetically. As first, we have Astonishia Story. Blade Dancer by Nippon Ichi Software. Blazing Souls Ecolette. Strategy RPG game from ID Factory, so it's a bit like Agorist on the PlayStation 3, but then a portable version, and of course another story and other characters, but it's the same kind of people who make Agorist, and it's it looks a bit the same battle system. A game I heard many people talk about with high praises is of course Breath of Fire 3. And yeah, I still have to check that out actually. Cars 2, worthless game. Then a game I still want to check out one day is Clash of Heroes 1. And yeah, Dungeon Crawler. Looks very interesting. Another one of my favorites. I played it from start to finish on the PlayStation Portable, and this was actually my first Disgaea I ever played. And well, with my favorite characters, Lahal, Edna and Flon, Disgaea 1. Great game. Dragoneers Aurea by Koei. Yeah, my favorite series, well, for golf that is, Everybody Golf. Japanese styled golf, very fun to play, like Everybody Golf 2 is. And then Fate Extra by Axis. Very, very Japanese, Japanese game. Scissors, rock, paper kind of RPG. Yeah, very Japanese. I recommend check it out on YouTube if you like it or not. But yeah, it was the box edition, so I just picked it up. And well, have not played it much actually. Field Commander. That's basically the Advance Wars for the PlayStation Portable. Combat strategy. Ah ja, dan this series. Final Fantasy 1. Final Fantasy 2. Final Fantasy 4. Final Fantasy 7 Crisis Core. Which for me, I was a little bit disappointed about the battle system. It's very uneasy selecting items or skills with the left and the right trigger. Final Fantasy Dissidia 012. It's a fighting game, and well, I'm glad I was able to watch Nightshade play with his Let's Play channel, play this game, so I can at least enjoy the game, because it's a game I'm not able to play myself. And yeah, Final Fantasy Tactics, great, great series, always has been. Generation of Chaos by ID Factory, which I still have to check out, actually. Ah yeah, Gran Turismo. Another one like, ah yeah, Grand Theft Auto, Vice City. And of, Growlancer, Wayfarer of Time. Another very nice RPG game. Then the Gungnir. I think this was the strategy RPG. Gurumin, I picked up for a few euros. It looks a little bit fighting RPG-ish, so I just picked it up. Then a visual novel of Hakuoki, and this is the first one, The Demon of the Fleeting Blossom. There is a second one, which is a visual novel with a little bit of RPG gameplay in it, and I still need to buy the second Hakuoki. But still has postponed it to try out a Harvest Moon, Innocent Life. Jeanne d'Arc, level 5, tactical RPG. Or strategy RPG, one of the best for the PlayStation Portable. If you enjoy strategy RPGs and you have not checked out Jeanne d'Arc yet, highly recommendable. Key of Heaven. Nights in the Nightmare. Very, very, very strange game. Yeah, very strange. Check out your gameplay on YouTube if you want to see what strange gameplay is. This sure is one. Then another great series which I love very much. This game was sent to me from Chris in the USA, which I'm still very glad, thankful to him for sending me this. This game, which I enjoyed very much. It's in the category one of my favorite RPGs for the PlayStation Portable. Legends of Heroes, Tear of Vermilion. Then Legends of Heroes 3, Song of the Ocean, which I still have to play. And from the new series of Legend of Heroes, Legends of Heroes Trails in the Sky. Let's say that is Legends of Heroes 4 and the first part of a new series. So I still have to play this one. I want to play 2 and 3 first. But I heard Trails in the Sky is the best Legend of Heroes on the PlayStation Portable. Then een Square Enix Lords of Arcana. I don't know if this will be interesting for me. But it's Square Enix. in RPG. Another great game. Exceed, really, to my opinion, this is a very good Exceed game. It's not just a port, but a really upgrade from the original Lunar Silver Star story. If I'm correct, Silver Star Harmony, sorry. Great game, great RPG. If you hadn't played it, play it. It's a great game. And Luxor, just to play in the train or whenever I like. Luxor is, great game. Then two very enjoyable games. Metal Gear Acid. I like Acid much more than Solid. Basically because this is turn-based and the card system, which you have to collect cards to do skills and all the other stuff. Yeah, very enjoyable. I hope to see a Metal Gear Acid 3 someday. And then the sequel, of course, Metal Gear Acid 2. Metal Gear Solid. That was the visual novel, which I still have to read. Metal Gear Solid Portable Ops. Another game that I enjoyed very much. Very simple, basic game, but it uses a battle system like Tales games, and that is Mimana Aya Chronicles. Love to play this game, and I had no problems finishing it from start to end. And well, basically I had a hard time finding this, but gladly I found one here in the Netherlands. Persona 1 for the PlayStation Portable. And then, of course, yeah, Persona 2 for the PlayStation Portable, Innocent Sin. And, of course, the PlayStation 3 Portable. Persona 3 Portable. Great game. I'm now playing FES and having a great time. Phantom Brave by Nippon Ichi Software. Originally it was released on the PlayStation 2. Another strategy RPG game, but very, very different than your normal game. You can convert stuff you find on the battlefield, like plants and something, to monsters. And yeah, plays very different than your usual strategy RPG. Phantom Star Portable. Populocroix. And that's, well, basic. I think it was an RPG released in the first year of the PlayStation Portable. And when I was playing it at those days, I liked it very much. I tried replaying it lately, but didn't enjoy it as much as I did when there were just a few RPGs for the PlayStation Portable. Poplocroix. And other strategy RPG, which I'm still glad that I still have to play. And this one, Engungnir, I really hope they are bringing me the gameplay that I like. That is Ragnarok Tactics. Yeah, I hope it's a good strategy RPG. Silverfall. Oh. Spectral Souls Resurrection of the Ethereal Empire. If you like your strategy RPGs hard, this is a real good recommendation. This is truly not an easy game. And then, Star Ocean, first departure. Star Ocean, of course, the second one, second evolution. Tactics Ogre, Let's Cling Together. Great strategy RPG. Very deep game. Tales of Eternia. And correct me if I'm wrong, in the USA it's Destiny 2. One of my favorite tales on the PSP. Well, that's not hard, but it's a great, great Tales of games. Tales of game. And it was for the PSP. And love this much. Very, very much. And this is the Tales of game I like the least from all the Tales that I played. Tales of the World, Radiant Mystery Mythology. Valkyria 2 Chronicles. And basically I still have to play the Valkyria on the PlayStation 3, so I haven't touched this one. Valkyrie Profile Lannet. The first White Knight Chronicles. Ys, the Ark of Nepotism. And the boxed version of Ys 7. And the last game, like the DS, the last games are always Yu-Gi-Oh! Something, Tag Force. And I lost interest in the Yu-Gi-Oh! Games. So that's the game for the PlayStation Portable and the Vita that I have at this moment. There are still quite a few for the PlayStation Portable that are on my wishlist. And they are getting very hard to find. So, but I'm not in a hurry. But, maybe one day and maybe not. Thank you for watching again to one of my videos. I hope to you see some games you like and are still available. Then I wish you all the fun with the gaming on which console or handheld you are playing. And we'll see each other next time. Bye bye from